this race.
Well, if the video appears to be what it seems to be, it's absolutely stunning. For weeks, I have been calling for a smoking gun. This sure looks like the barrel is still hot. Now, we need a further investigation, but the question becomes, if this could have happened in Georgia, in Michigan, in Pennsylvania, in Arizona, in Nevada, too, can't say for sure, but we can't rule it out either. It would certainly explain Joe Biden's massive vote totals for a guy that couldn't get anyone to a rally. Heck, he outperformed Obama and Clinton, yet he lost all but one bellwether county, meaning the counties that have a 100% voting record for the presidential winner, he lost all those counties. Where he did get huge vote totals, though, big cities, Atlanta, Detroit, what you're seeing there, cities with powerful and yet often crooked Democrat Party machines in place. Now, there's more of this evidence. This is a witness from Wayne County, Michigan, testifying before the State House Committee investigating election integrity. Watch this exchange.
Would your supervisor say this to all of you publicly? In other words, he would say, today, the date we're going to use is whatever.
Yes. That's the announcement.
In other words, you had the phony date of the day.
The announcement they will make. Yes.
That's the announcement they would make. She just admitted to backdating mail-in ballots herself. That amounts to a confession.
Oh, almost done.
Not that she's the criminal. I'm sure the supervisor was making her do this, but the same woman told the committee.
Are you?
Other voters who requested mail-in ballots were also allowed to vote again in person. Now, all of this, the confession right there, usually amounts to the strongest evidence there is. That's just eyewitness testimony. That's testimony from the person who did it, backdating mail-in ballots. The only harder evidence that you could find, of course, is video of the crime taking place. Check that off the list, too, now. But what will Michigan and Georgia, when video was filmed, what will the elected leaders in those states do about this now? They better have the courage to stand up and do something. Control the legislature in both of those states. Now is the time to be bold.
Look, honey.
It's up to all of us.
No, I don't.
Put the pressure on those lawmakers.
No, I don't.
Hey, Shay lit the cat on fire. Is here with the little gas can up there?
That's funny.
In Georgia on election night after that supposed water main break.
They're like, no.
Was the voice narrating that smoking gun surveillance
video. I gotta fix your hair.
She was the woman addressing the Senate committee explaining where that video came from.
She looks almost like an evil clown. Don't she up there?
And she joins us now on this program.
Evil clown smile, not frown. It's a funny drawing. That's a funny drawing.
What, mine?
Member of the community, and if you come out with it, I trust you, Jack.
If you write loves, then why'd you set it on fire?
Thank you, Grant, and if you come out with it, I trust you, Jack. We're on same footing here. Good to be here.
All right, so tell me, where did you get the video? How did you come across this video? I know you said you just got a chance to go through it.